Alrighty then, let's get on with this fucking video. Anyway, this is the Fortress of World 4. This fortress is probably the biggest pain in the ass fortresses so far in this game. Especially for the secret exit of this level, which is probably one of the most frustrating secret exits that you can actually come across in this game. Although, saying that, I'm not entirely sure because I haven't actually tried to record any of the further on secret exits yet. I'm trying to keep off my bad habit of not recording everything and then having to do commentary later. I used to have a really bad habit of doing that, and then, like, you know, and have games done on my computer forever, and then I just wouldn't do anything. Having commentary done at the same time is probably the best way to do it. I actually think that this video is going to be full of a lot of death scenes for myself. I mean, I'm actually really quite surprised, because I'm not going to edit my deaths out for this level just to show how frustrating this is. This castle is probably one of the most frustrating levels in this game that I actually have come across. By that, I mean the entire fucking game itself. I have beat this game already, and I can't believe how annoying this castle was to record. If you want to know the video timeline, even though you already know if you're watching it on YouTube, it's 11 minutes and 55 seconds. I actually really cannot believe I fucking took this long trying to get both exits of this castle. And I really wanted to get it all done in the one video. I didn't want to have to split it. I could have. I really could have. I really wanted to at one point as well, but I'm not going to do that. Yay, I got a 1-up, which is entirely fucking useless to me right now, so I really don't care. Bum bum. Okay, oh god. Okay, you gotta watch out for these big blocks right here. If you get squished by even one of them, even a little one, you're dead. Pretty much. If it falls on top of your head, you're entirely dead. There's nothing you can do about it. Mario can't lift it up and throw it off. It's made out of steel or whatever the hell it's actually meant to be made out of. And it just can't do anything. You'll die. That's pretty much it. Okay. What you gotta do here is basically just wait for this one to fall, then climb up here, then climb up here, and then run and get his coin, then oh my god, turn back and survive somehow. Anyway, there's coins for here if you want. Then there's only one there. Okay, there it is. Same way, be any of the Koopa Kids, really, just jump in her head 3 times. Just avoid the rings. It's pretty straightforward to avoid them. Oh, god damn it. Anyway, he'll run over to the big castle, obviously. Well, she will, whatever, it doesn't really matter. I really don't give a fuck. Anyway, moving on. Fuck you, Toad, I'm not gonna get you this time. Save. Yay. Yay. Okay, next. Okay, I'm gonna die continuously, time and time and time again, in doing the secret exit. The secret exit is probably the most frustrating exit that I've had to do this far. I've tried multiple attempts in different ways and different strategies to get in them, and only by luck is it that I all seem to make it through. However, if you want to copy the way that I do it through luck and it successfully does it for you, then sure, go ahead, but I know there is a safe way to do it. At the time, I really couldn't remember how the hell I did it the first time, and I was really, screw it, I just want this video over and done with. It's past 11 minutes, and I don't like showing off that I have the ability to go over 11 minutes with Mario videos, because so many people bloody complain about the fact of me not doing, you know, 11 minutes videos, and it's like, well, imagine if I could upload the whole game in one video, which I probably could. I'm not doing it. Sorry, this is a walkthrough. I'm not giving around. I'm not just showing where the free coins is. I'm showing you how to beat all the levels and get all the secret houses as well. I'm not on like, well, I'm not like some of the walkthroughs out there or some of the walkthroughing sites, but we'll do that to you. I'm gonna show you the entire bloody game because that's how I roll. Not gonna gimp you out of anything. You came here to see a video, you came here to see everything that I do. I'm not gonna short edit everything out. Commentary and entertainment are a plus in any sort of video. If you don't like commentary, then find a fucking user who doesn't do commentary then. There's millions of them out there on YouTube, and personally, I really don't give a crap for them. I don't give a crap for anyone who basically doesn't make any effort to show their voice in a video game. If you're recording a video game, you might as well talk at the same time you're thinking as you're playing. Why not just speak your thoughts? Doesn't make any sense. If you don't have a good voice, then sure, that's fine, fair enough. If you don't like your voice and you don't want to display it to the internet, then sure, go ahead. I don't like my voice, but I display it to the internet anyway. I enjoy talking for recording a video. Okay, you're gonna see here perfectly of an example of what I mean, why this is so fucking hard. There we go. If I jumped, I probably would have made it. But unfortunately, I pressed 1 rather than 2. However, we're gonna go back in and back in and back in and over and over and over again until we get it right. And this goes on for another about 6 minutes from now or something. I do this for about 6 minutes, basically. I power up, I think, oh, I'll just do the next room, I'll do it over and over again. But you understand how frustrating this can get. Imagine how I felt when I was recording this. To be honest with you, I'm getting sick of hearing about Mario. I mean, I get a lot of personal messages and comments a day about it. I really appreciate that people do that for my videos, but I like my other stuff as well, you know? I just don't like this game in particular. This isn't the only thing I've done. I kind of wish that people would pay attention to the other stuff, but whatever. And there's a perfect example. I got pissed off and I tried to rush and I died. I'm not editing at my devs because I want to show how annoying this fucking place can be. That's the sheer point of why I'm not editing at my devs. Anyway. Yeah, like I was saying, I kind of wish everyone would watch my other stuff as well. I mean, after this is done, I'm kind of going to expect, you know, at least some of the subscribers to come watch my other stuff at the same time. I don't want them to stick around for Mario and then bugger off somewhere else. That's kind of lame. Probably going to be playing a lot of classical games after this, like Diddy Kong Racing, and going to continue on with Banjo Kazooie and Majora's Mask. Really don't care who's done it at this point. Personally, I really enjoyed someone in particular's LP of Majora's Mask, but then again, I felt like he was a bit of a noob at it. That being said, he was good at the game. And see, I mean, it's well dying right here because of the fact that I screwed everything up. So I just exited the level rather. You gotta, it's in between all those stone tails. It's like in level with the second one on the left-hand side of that room. This secret exit drove me insane. It really did. After this, I had a swig of alcohol, and I thought, I can't do it. I can't record anymore. Not tonight. Not tonight. I done this at like 11 p.m. after I came home from work, and that day of work was so fucking frustrating because of the fact of what happened there. And I'm not gonna talk about it. That's my own personal detail bullshit. God. Boom, boom. Anyway, Diddy Kong Racing is probably gonna be a big problem to record in general. Anyway, N64 games generally have the aspect ratio of like 4:3, which is 640x480. YouTube does widescreen now, and then I have to do fake HD for it. It's probably going to be 4:3 plus fake HD, which is basically like an aspect ratio of 1080x720, but rendered to a point of 4:3.
Which is good in some ways, and then it's not. See, I just fucked up again. That's the point. You gotta be so fast, but you gotta be so careful as well to notice that you won't die. And this is probably gonna be the time that I actually do it correctly. And I think, fuck it, going in, I'm just gonna get a power up and run for it. I'm not even gonna bother anymore at this point. But I could probably do the decon racing because of my time limit and stuff in like about 5 parts. That's the problem with it. I kinda wanna go to it because of the fact that I could do it in 5 parts. I could get it done in 5 fucking parts. Oh my god, it'd be such like an accomplishment for me because when I was a kid, I used to play that game endlessly. Like, every weekend, I would challenge myself to see if I could beat my time and beating it. And every single time, it always wanted to be over a course of a weekend. And bear in mind, this was when I was a kid, and this is when I had no homework, no work. Anything. I could just sit there with my friends and play fucking two-player adventure mode. Yeah, you can actually play two-player adventure mode. I'll probably talk about that when I actually get to play it. But no, I would just sit there with my friend and play two-player adventure mode. And when my other friends came around, we would just sit and play battle mode, and I'd be so happy about it. Oh, by the way, you can probably just run right across and jump in there. I just realized that looking at a video right now. Oh my god, I can't believe that. That's probably how I did it the first time. Holy shit. Oh my god, I'm gonna go fucking slam my head against my keyboard now. Course clear. Oh my god. What the fuck did I do? Anyway, I'm gonna head over to the goddamn other levels soon later on, but I've got a bunch of stuff to do before I record the rest of the commentary. So, see you all guys later. See you guys all later, or whatever. I'm all confused now. Later.